Perfection. Yeah, that's quite a different game from the last game. It's going out very slowly. Yeah, I'm killing that one. I think I'd rather just kill it now. Instead of waiting. Because if I wait, he might just put an enchantment on it. But he might also God's willing or plus two plus to it, and that would be very bad for me. Because if he does that, I have no way of dealing with it. Like if he goes, like ordeal, I go kill it, he goes pump it. Then he has a 2-2 RP with an ordeal on it, and there's nothing that I can do to stop it. Like if his guy was white, then things would be different. Because even if it grows very big, I could still just glare it. But since it's black, I think I have to just pull a trigger and do this now. Yeah, but also killing this one. Now I could have waited. Yeah, he would definitely have enchanted that with something. Yeah, that was probably a bad play. So just played like the 1/4. Because he would definitely like this is a guy that doesn't die. So he would probably just have enchanted it if he could. With like an ordeal or something. Or a bestow guy. I want another read the bones. I certainly want the planes. It's gonna take a while for me to make use of that read the bones. I think I'd rather just not have it. I mean, I will have time. Like, look at this game. I'm at 20 life, and every card in my hand gains life pretty much. But I will have stuff to do with my mana. Yeah, I don't think I want this. Okay, I mean, this is worse because if I knew the next card was gonna be a land, then I would just have kept the read bonus and drawn the fifth land. But I really wanted to hit my fifth land drop next turn, so I think that was a fine decision. You're the great merchant. I hope I draw a whip. Acceptable. Don't want to play the Eidolon here because he might just have a removal spell and I want him to use it on this. I mean, this guy blocks his Intimidator and drains him, so this is a natural threat that he. Yes, he doesn't block it anymore. Yep. Well, I guess I will have to play the Eidolon and try and trade. Sorry, try and raid. Though on a block, he can't divine verdict it. He only saves one damage. He has divine verdict. That's gonna be really bad for me. But can I? Oh no, it doesn't actually save one damage because I can't gain one life. Yeah, this is just bad. Yeah, this is much better. I get to drain him for one. Okay. I mean, my hand is very good for erasing, that's for sure. Now the question is, do I want to expose myself to divine verdict? He's attacking. This play is really bad if he doesn't have Divine Verdict. Because I just gain 4 life. So his attack is a net gain 1 for me. But I think I can't actually beat it. I don't know. Yeah, I'll take it. Fine. Yes, I know he probably doesn't have the -4/-4 thing. Or he would, just cast it and attack. Gonna discard those two. I think it's better to discard than to cast this. Because then I can regenerate from sip. Oh, come on. How are you so lucky? Yeah, I gotta just block and regenerate. Yeah, there's nothing that really punishes me here, except for like Hero's downfall, but at this point my guy is just not huge anymore, so I don't even care that much. Yeah, that's if I just take it's 4 damage, yeah. I'm gonna discard those. Oh, one play I think I could have made. Was to just regenerate before blocking last turn. So he can't divine braid it. And then I block, and if he divine braids it, it removes from combat. Then if he waits for little damage, it regenerates, it removes from combat. Yeah, why not think of that? Yeah, it makes perfect sense. I should have done that. Would have been a lot better. I'm still kind of winning the race. What? He's gonna plus one on a lifelink me. No, okay. Okay, let's gain some life if something goes very wrong. So is that. Yep. Okay.